This is a demo about the integration between Sonata Nexus Lifecycle and Fortify Software Security Center. So this bundle contains both a parser to import Sonata Nexus Lifecycle scan result into SSE, and also an integration service to synchronize always constantly the results of Sonata within the Software Security Center dashboard. Okay, so here you can see from the Micro Focus marketplace where this integration is, so you can easily download and start using. And here you have all the explanation about this integration, this plugin, that is both, as I said, a parser to import Sonatype scan result in Software Security Center, and a service that will look for new reports in Nexus Lifecycle and will push the findings to Fortify Software Security Center. So here you can see the Software Security Center, that is where we centralize all the result by Fortify Static Code Analyzer, Fortify WebISP agent, and also Sonatype and another tool. And so you have the list of all the applications that have been scanned, and here you can go in details in the application details and vulnerability found. Instead, in here, you see the IQ server, that is the Sonatype dashboard for Nexus Lifecycle. So you can see, have an overview of all the vulnerability violation found. Then you can go to the org and policy, see the application that are in place, and you can go within the application to check both the violation policies and license information, okay? So what I did, I just download this plugin and import, first of all, the parser, the Sonatype parser within the Software Security Center. So from administration, plugin, parser, you see I already imported the Sonatype vulnerability parser and I enable it. It's very easy to do because you just click on new and you import the jar file and that's it. You just need to enable them. So this is the first step. To enable and import enable the parser of Sonatype within Software Security Center. The second step would be to go within the service where the Fortify Sonatype bundle service is, the integration server, and just start it. And this will go and start listening if there is a new scan of Sonatype so that it can push to Software Security Center. So let's do it. In here, you can see that I'm within a project that is called Riches, that is a demo Java project, that is a Java application. And then you see that I start using the Nexus Sonatype command line interface. Okay, so simply by use Java, I use the CLI of Sonatype. And then I say that you need to upload the result of the scan to SSE. Okay, to the Riches application, then I provide the credential for Sonatype IQ server, and then I provide all the jar file, all the dependency I want Sonatype to check. So I just run the scan, okay, and this we run the scan across all the dependency that we found, and we'll upload the result to the Sonatype IQ server, okay? So this is the first step that it's just done. So if we see in here, in the Sonatype IQ server, and we go to the report, we see that just a few seconds ago, there is a new report. So the Sonatype scan has been already uploaded in the Sonatype IQ server, okay? And if we check the services, we see that now there is a continuously checking for new update. And as soon as ready, it will push the result of the Sonatype scan result from the IQ server to the Fortify Software Security Center. So you see that now it just upload the new result and upload and synchronize with Software Security Center. So if we go to Software Security Center now, okay, there will be an application, okay, called Riches Sonatype, where all this information has been published and synchronized. So if you go in here, you see that there will be several vulnerability. Okay, there is also a new tab called open source. Okay, and so we can see all the result of the sonotype scan that have been pushed by the IQ server. So we can go in here and we see the details of the vulnerability. So the file name, the priority, which kind of vulnerability it is, reference you see to CVE and CWE, and so on. And you can see also the result from the audit tab, for some filtering by analysis type, you see the sonotype, and you can go into the details of the vulnerability. So you have the explanation of the vulnerability itself. Okay. You have all the information about the CVE. This is coming from the National Vulnerability Database, for instance, and all the information about license, vulnerability, and so on, and the component details. And you see, moreover, that there is a link to the IQ server. So if I want more information, I can go to the IQ server, and I will have all the information I need about it. So I can go into it and have all the information that's needed. So this is the first part of the demo, where I show how the Sonatype Nexo Lifecycle Integration work with Fortify SSE. Okay. The second part is about another integration that you can find always in the Micro Focus marketplace. This integration is called Fortify Source and Lib Scanner. So this is a scanner that provides common line interface to enable the scan, and with this scanner, I want to show some new that is in technology we preview that is called susceptibility analysis. Okay, so with this feature that has been co-developed by Sonatype and Fortify, we can scan the application, and then we can also understand if there is the vulnerability found by Sonatype is relevant to write the code because has been invoked and controllable by the code itself. Okay, so this is the susceptibility analysis that I wanted to show. So in order to show you this this kind of feature, okay, I just need to download the Fortify Source Lib Scanner that I already did, and then I need to launch it. So if you can see in here, I'm within another project that is a Struth project, and then what I use the Source and Lib Scanner, okay, and then I use the dependency feature for the suitability analysis, and then what I need to do, I need to just specify that I want to scan Sonatype, and I want to use the IQ server that I have installed locally, okay? The app ID that I have in Sonatype, that is in this case is Struts Showcase Sonatype 2.5, and then the credential for it. Then you see that then I will upload the result to Software Service Center, so I need to specify also the application in Software Service Center and the token that I will use for Software Service Center to upload the thing. So in here, I just start the scan, okay? And so this will scan the project by using this new functionality, and we will check not only for the vulnerability in the dependency itself that Sonatype already does, but it will check also to understand if the vulnerability has been found by the from the source code and have been invoked and controllable from the source itself. That means that it will prioritize you can prioritize the vulnerability based on the fact if the source code is really invoked or not, control or not the vulnerability found by Sonatype. Here you can see how the Sonatype scan has been completed and uploaded to the IQ server, and then how the Sonatype-based rules has been generated and used by the Fortify SCA scan in order to do this susceptibility analysis based on the rules created by Sonatype. So if we go to the Sonatype IQ server, we will be able to see that there are new vulnerability found for the Strat Showcase Sonatype. And moreover, this information has been uploaded also to Software Security Center. So if you go in Software Security Center, okay, and we go to the same Strat Showcase Sonatype, we go into the same version, and we can see from the open source tab that there are many vulnerability found, and we will be able to see if one of these vulnerability has been used by the suitability analysis. Okay, so for example, we go in several of Strat score, and we see that there are some vulnerability, okay, that are both controllable. You see that controllable is yes, and invoked by the source code itself. So here we are telling that not only that the Sonatype version of Strat Core 2 specific TSPA name has been is present within this application that is called Strat Showcase Sonatype, but also that has been this kind of vulnerability is controllable, yes, and is invoked. That means that is for sure a vulnerability. It's not a false positive, and so you need to prioritize this. Okay, so this is what we show here. And moreover, when is it both invoked and controllable, we can see the evidence. So if we go in the evidence, we see exactly where is the source code that invoke this vulnerability found by Sonatype. And you see that is in the parse name space, in this specific method is the point HF. Why? Maybe because if we go to this more information to the CVE, let's see what is the reason of it. Okay, if we scroll down, we see that Apache Shorts use this method that is called parse name in a space, and it looks like that is performing insufficient validation. So there is not enough validation for it. That's why it's marked. And here you can see in Fortify itself in Software Security Center that is actually found this. And you can see from the entry point, for instance, how this URI variable has been populated by a request parameter, and then how it is propagated between different classes, different methods, and so on, up to the arrive to the point when it used this method that is found by Sonatype. So you see in here with this susceptibility analysis how we can prioritize the Sonatype result and focus only on the vulnerability that really matters.